Dan Larson here at the photo booth with stuff sent into the P.O. box by Toy Galaxy viewers. Up first is Asher from Indianapolis, Indiana. Check out the Instagram Ash at AshBagums88 on Instagram. Asher had some stuff that wasn't really fitting with the collection anymore, decided to send it in so we could take a look. Strategic pouring. Right out of the gate here, I know that we've got a lot of Dragon Ball Z, which is the if we're putting it in wheelhouse terms, it is the part that's absent from my wheelhouse. I don't know how to extend that analogy out. I know that if something is very good for you and you're really good at it, it's in your wheelhouse. But this is out of my wheelhouse. I don't know that it's ever been a part of my wheelhouse. It's, this dude is got a messed up foot, but it was tactfully painted. I don't know what happened there. There was definitely an issue with that figure, but, we've got 1, 2, 3. I know this is, Android 18. So we got Dragon Ball. This is Dragon Ball. I don't know if this dog is supposed to be part of it. I don't know if this animal cracker cookie thing is supposed to be part of it. This is, again, not my area of expertise. We've got two more here. Three more, technically, I think. This guy. I think these guys are somewhat related. I don't know. He's got a little swirly do, and then this guy back here. All right. So, I don't know who any of these guys are. I think this is Android 18 over here. The girl. But the good news is that Asher included a note, and I'm going to read right off this note. We have... Let's see, we've got blonde female is Android 18, guy with spiky blonde hair, blue and orange gi and dog chewed is Super Saiyan adult Gohan. This guy, maybe? Spiky hair? Yeah, that one, all right. Dog Super Saiyan adult Goku's person. The fat pink one is Majin Buu. He's got his dog B and Demon King Deborah as a cookie. All right, there we go. That is a thing. Short pink one is Majin Buu. Anyway, that's a bunch of Dragon Ball guys. So we've also got over here, we got some Star Wars. Oh, wait, actually, in the back here, we've got a knockoff SH Figure Arts. I have to reconsult my note. Knockoff SH Figure Arts. Kakashi Hatake from Naruto. He's one of Naruto's. Anyway, so that's that guy. I can tell it's a knockoff because it's not in very good shape. Hang on. Or maybe he's got interchangeable faces. I think that's what it is. What is this tape here? Okay, yeah, I thought it was, hang on. I thought it was, busted. But, yeah, I think it's just the head and face is supposed to be, we've got masked face, and this is unmasked. So, yeah, this looks like the head, and then that snaps in there. Ah, okay, so yeah, the hair can snap on here. This is riveting, right? I think that, okay, so there we go. Yeah, and then that, I don't know, this is weird. I don't know why it snapped on here like this. There we go, all right. But no, that, okay, well, yeah, maybe. Anyway, that's who that guy is. Back to Star Wars, back to the thing I know a little bit about. We've got Mace Windu in here. These are the older figures. Because they're all like actiony. Woo. Over here. So we got Mace Windu. Count Dooku. Yeah. He's got his lightsaber. fighting action. We've got Obi-Wan. Oh, I don't miss this era of figures at all. Just like in the movie. Just like, oh, that was almost, there it is. All right. Yeah, no, I see it now. This is, yeah. Yeah, no, I saw this movie. And then we've also got General Grievous. With, did he come with all four lightsabers? One, two, three. He's got three lightsabers here, but I have a whole bin full of extra lightsabers and stuff. Oh, he doesn't, he doesn't have like animated action. This is just like the bifurcated arms action. No cape, but yeah, mostly pretty poseable. Not bad. It's pretty amazing that they made as many different General Grievous figures as they did over the years, because it's a really complicated design, and yeah, most of them are all right. But all right, that's all that stuff. That's all from Asher. Asher, thank you very much for sending that stuff in. Next up is Chris from Norton, Mass. He is TheCollector77 on Instagram. Chris saw this piece. I already read the note, spoiler alert. Chris saw this piece, and he was pretty sure that I would like it. He says he knows it's not an action figure, but that, you know, he was pretty sure it would look good on a shelf regardless. On my shelf specifically, and that's why he picked it up. There is nothing to not like about this. I don't know how well this is going to show up on screen here, but hang on. Let me snap it into the base. Yep, let me just snap it right in the base here. Hang on. There we go. And it's harder than it looks. There we go. All right. So he's got a little bit of a lean to him, but let me put some color in the back behind him so you can actually see this thing. There we go. Oh, man, look at that thing. it's like it's made out of ice. Ah, it's so nice. You can actually see like the core fighter in here. And it's like the way it's made, I want to take it apart. I want to separate it, but it's not going to separate. And yeah, it's not poseable, but, you know, it's just meant to be sort of a commemorative 40th anniversary sort of thing. It's on the box. It says Mobile Suit Gundam Internal Structure RX-78-2, obviously. 40th anniversary from Pip. Anyway, it's, man, just a really, really interesting piece. Unique. It's got all the detail there. I'm sure there's different versions of this, obviously color. I mean, even on the box, it shows that there's an A and a B version here. So, you know, you could get both. I wonder if there's one that's actually got the half painted, half unpainted. I wonder. That's probably what that is. I don't know. This is awesome. Of those, if I had seen those on the shelf, I definitely would have grabbed this one for sure. So that's really great. Chris knows the kind of stuff I like, Gundam and translucent stuff. So, Chris, that's awesome. Thank you very much for sending that. Next up is Josh and his son, Alex. I think this is the second box they sent. I want to say there was a box back, probably in December sometime, which had a lot of really great stuff in it. And this box is pretty much the same. A lot of great stuff in it. First off, here we have a bag of Constructicons. G1, I'm assuming. They look G1. I don't know if these are reissue, re-release. We can check real quick here. If we can find a date. 1984. Yep, Hasbro, 1984. Wow, that's sharp. These look like they got rub symbols. This is already connected to this. Let's see if I can pull that out. That's incredible. This is in really, really nice shape. This guy is always busted. And these, man, these are like clean and they feel like they've never been used. They are, yeah, I keep checking to see if they're actually legit originals, and they are. When I was a kid, this was the only one I actually got. I was not My parents weren't in the position to buy the whole set, you know, the whole box set when it came out. I thought I was just going to build them on my own. And if nothing else, I was like, nah, you know, this is, of all of them, he was the Constructicon Bone. I don't know if this was Scrapper, Bone Crusher. I think this is Bone Crusher. I don't know. But this is the only one I had, actually, as a kid. I prefer to put my money into Dinobots than the Constructicons. I don't even know if I knew anybody that had the entire thing. This, speaking of the entire thing, is pretty much the entire thing here. Hang on. I don't know how to get that to release, and I don't want to force it, because this thing's in such great condition. But yeah, it looks like everybody's here. Everybody's accounted for. Missing weapons and stuff, of course, including Devastator's big blaster itself. But I'm pretty sure, based on other recent G1 Transformer acquisitions, that I have those missing pieces. We have hips or crotch plate or whatever. We've got the wing. We've got both hands. All right, so we're missing a fist. No big deal. That is, I mean, just the incredible condition of these figures themselves, especially, God, this chrome. Man, this chrome is just sharp as heck. And like, just they feel nice. They're smooth. They're still tight. Like, these are in just incredible shape. I don't know. I don't think I've seen Constructicons this clean since they were released. So that is amazing. Next up, that's not even everything that's in the box here. Next up, we've got Slythe from Thundercats. In really nice shape with his weapon. I've got a couple of DC Universe Classics, or I think this one, I think he's from DC Universe Classics. He might have been from whatever the line was right after it, just one of the DC Multiverse lines. I don't remember exactly. Seems like he's got some stiff joints here. I'm not going to force those. I don't want to bust them up. But so we got Blue Beetle with his wings, both extended. Oh no, just regular. Okay, so we've got extended and then not extended. You just take them off. And then we've also got Green Arrow here, who, again, both of these guys are in incredible shape. Really, really nice condition. What it is, DC Universe Classics, just a really great line. And a line that I got in real, real, real late, and I was really disappointed that it took me so long to get into it. And I can't tell you why, because I don't remember why I didn't get into it. It had nothing to do with, like, not liking DC or anything. I think part of it was just, I don't know that I was spending that much on action figures at the time. I was still doing a lot of vintage stuff. And, you know, I had missed, for whatever reason, I had missed Superman and Batman and, yeah, I don't know. Just, I wasn't that into, I was definitely more of a Marvel than DC person. So if I had to pick between Marvel and DC, I would have gone Marvel. But I don't know. I just, that sort of period that this line was out and really doing big, I just, for whatever reason, I wasn't buying them. I bought some. I got into it real late. I want to say that, like, Magog might have been one of the first ones I bought. And that was, like, really near the end of the line. I think it was probably just a price thing, too, because, like, Black Series hadn't come out yet. Legends really hadn't ramped up. And so, you know, even $15 was like, ah, oh, that's too much for a figure. And now it's like $22, $25, okay, whatever. And then you buy like four of them in a week. And it's just, I don't know, things are out of control now. But these are great figures. These are in great condition. Again, Green Arrow's got all four of his trick arrows here, as well as his bow. So that's insane. Blue Beetle. I definitely don't have this Blue Beetle. So that's awesome. I think I have that Green Arrow. I might not have all of his arrows. So that's awesome. But this figure, I have a translucent version of him that's not as poseable. So it's really cool to have that one as well, because I've definitely never had that one in my collection. In here, we've got a couple of Predators. Be careful with these. I don't know how early in the Predator, NECA Predators they are, and I know the earlier ones can be a bit more fragile. So we've got, oh, cool. They included packaging. We got Warrior Predator, that's this guy, and Snake Predator over here. I assume this goes with Warrior Predator. I would be wrong. I would be right. Let's just go with. I can't tell where that snaps on. Well, he's already got his little laser up there. It's got to go over here. Right? Is there a peg somewhere? Huh. Maybe. Well, I'm going to have to look that up and see how that goes. But yeah, I want to be careful with these guys. You know, the funny thing about the Predators is, like, I fought and fought and fought against Predator for a really long time. And there were just, there's too much of a fan base, I assume this goes with this guy, for Predators out there. And over the years of these, you know, photo booth videos and posting on Instagram and stuff, people would tag me in pictures and say, Dan, you got to check this figure out. You got to check these Predator figures out. They're so amazing. I love Predators. And I would just be like, I don't get how that franchise became a thing. Like, how did Predator figures suddenly become, you know, so popular that people were just collecting them? There's not even a good movie out right now. There's not even, like, is the mythology really that interesting? And I think I was just overthinking it. And at a certain point, you know, a few got sent in, and I got to actually take a look at them. And then I just started buying a couple of my own, and now I have, like, a really big collection of Predator figures. Not big collection. I've probably got, like, I don't know, like 10 or 12 at this point. And, but I've actually bought, like, 4 or 5 of my own. And it's just, it's an interesting sort of commentary on the, oh, this guy's tail is either broken or not glued. Oh, okay. I thought it broke. It just wasn't connected properly there. Or maybe it's broke. I don't know. I can glue that back in. but that was part of it is, you know, NECA's Aliens and Predator figures. And this one feels like it's an early one. It feels like I don't really want to touch the joints or move the joints at all. Because I feel like they're just going to snap. I'll heat this up and see if I can do something with it. I do like this one. This is the, like, you know, clear dome. I don't know. I think that mouth extends. It looks like it extends. But these early ones, like, they're gorgeous figures. But, man, were they just brittle. And I just had a real negative view of NECA at the time, and I just couldn't spend money on figures that I knew. And that was, like, carryover from McFarlane. Like, you just got to the point where you're like, I can't even take them out of the package. They're going to break. Like, what's the point? But, you know, fans of the line reassured me that they had changed. They'd made improvements. The joints were, they were using different materials. The joints were better. And they were right. And, you know, I just last year I bought that NECA New York Comic Con 2-pack, the Yellow Lantern Predator with the Hal Jordan Green Lantern figure, or John Stewart, you can use whichever head. And I love that set. I love that Predator. I saw that Predator on the pictures when they first released it, when they announced it, and I was like, that's fake. That's, like, a really cool custom that somebody made. And they announced that it was a real thing, and I was like, oh, shoot, I need to get that. That thing's amazing. So I don't know what, that seems like it's just the regular Xenomorph from the original Alien, I believe. This one, I don't know which one this is. He's got a skull with him, a Xenomorph skull. He's got his laser, which this looks like the same as the other laser over there. This one definitely snaps onto his back. That's the gun for the top. And then it's also got a Predator skull. So I don't know if that's, like, an Aliens versus Predator thing or a 2-pack or whatever, but it's the details incredible. They're not super posable. They need to find some way to work in, like, a better mid-torso thing here so they can actually, like, crouch down and get into that real Predator, like, you know, about to pounce up in the trees kind of position. But I dig them, and I've definitely come around on this line, and I really, really do like the Predator figures that I own. I couldn't tell you all their names. It's really just like, hey, that one looks cool. I'm gonna get that one, and that's pretty much how it goes. at that point, also have in this box, this is an extremely cool piece. There were a few lines that came out back in the early 2000s, I believe, from Stan Winston Creations. Stan Winston, the visual effects guy who worked on things like Jurassic Park, and I don't know, just like name a movie monster from the last, like, you know, 20, 25 years, and he was probably involved with it. But this one was Gargoyles. Not the Disney property, but just some absolutely incredible monsters and creatures, creature designs. Let's see if I can figure out how this thing goes. I think he sits back here, and then he pegs in here and here. Well, I could have it reversed. I think I might have it reversed. Let's try the other way. There we go. Just a really cool diorama piece. I don't know if he's supposed to, like, hold this thing. Er. I don't know. I'm gonna have to look up the packaging to see how this thing is actually supposed to fit. But you can see just from here, like, this was the era where McFarlane was still big and NECA was coming up. And it was all about, you know, limited posability, more about just sort of diorama display. Get all the detail in there. Don't worry too much about super articulation. This would be a totally different figure if it came out today. But still, and amazingly, this is just a gorgeous, gorgeous piece. Just a lot of expression and character in there. This one, I think, is called Elias. Yeah, he wrote Elias on here. I'll have to look up the line. Definitely something worth looking into. It reminds me of, like, you know, McFarlane had their Dragons line, which was just one of those things where, like, you know, they go, huh, what do we want to do this year? Let's do something different. Let's do something nobody else has done before. And so they pick a line and design some stuff, and you get a really cool figure like that out of it. Also in here, we've got a couple of Street Fighter figures. Ken and Ryu, and a couple of their alternate hands. These are from the... I would have thought these were the Soda Toys. Nope, Capcom, Playmore. I don't know those. Yeah, I was a Mortal Kombat guy, but it's cool. I don't mind having a couple of Street Fighter figures in my collection. You never know which characters you're going to need to put a photo together. It'll just have to have on the shelf. You know, this is a fighting episode of Dan in the Photo Booth. We got Predators, we've got Aliens, we've got Street Fighter, Dragon Ball Z, all kinds of stuff. This guy, I don't know. This is Juza. I don't know if this is Fist of the North Star, maybe? I'm not sure. Another really nice figure. Super poseable. I don't know if this is early... Yeah, I'm not even really sure what this is from. It says Kotobukiya on the card, so I guess that's what it is. But, probably early Revoltech? Yeah, that's right. Yeah, Kaido. Yeah, okay, so it's a Revoltech. Yeah, this is really nice. I believe it's Fist of the North Star. More fighting stuff. We've also got a couple of... Oh, we got Archangel Minimates. That's a really adorable one. We've got Marvel Universe Archangel. And... Gambit. Armored Cap. And then a... Tiny Gundam Deathsight. Which I did actually pick this one up. I love these figures. I just love Gundam in general, but I do really like this tiny line of figures. I did pick this one up at RetroCon last year. I wanted to pick up anything Gundam, and this was like the only thing I could find in the entire convention. Such a nice piece. Such incredible articulation, especially for such a tiny little figure. It's amazing that they were able to work this much detail into it and this much articulation. I'm sure it's just like a scaled down. They took the pattern from a larger figure, scaled it down, whatever. Just an incredible amount of detail. And it's like, to any other toy company, you want to just be like, hey, look, they did this with this. You can do a little bit better on whatever it is that you're making. What an incredible batch of stuff here. Just amazing, amazing. Spoiling me with all these cool figures and Transformers and stuff. Thank you very much to Josh and his son Alex. I don't think I mentioned they're from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. But thanks again to Asher, Chris, Josh, and his son Alex. Thank you for watching this and all of our videos. Hey, stay safe out there. Remember, we're all in this together. We're all a neighborhood of people around the world. Make good decisions for you, your family, and the people you've never met who you will be helping by doing the right thing. Stay home for a while. Follow me on Instagram @ToyGalaxy if you're in the position to help the channel grow. Please visit our Patreon at patreon.com/ToyGalaxy. Thanks. Later.